Let's turn our attention to tonight, the Toronto Maple Leafs in action. They've got four players in the top 10 of league scoring as we say hello to Jon Rosen ahead of the Leafs game against the Kings. Tonight, we're going to see speed versus strength in the Leafs-Kings matchup. How can the Kings use their strength to pull out a W here?
You know, it's an interesting question that was asked John Stevens earlier today during his media scrum. He was asked, can heavy still win in the National Hockey League? And he turned the question right back on the reporters. Well, did you see Washington play heavy last year? And the question, the answer is obviously yes. Winnipeg, another one of those teams in the Western Conference. It has a very good mix of that speed as well as that physical identity that they've always had. So that's what the Kings are trying to work to right now. They've always had that heavy play, that physical play. They're trying to get those mobile defensemen up in the play, wingers up to speed, as John Stevens talked about earlier today. But really, you know, as you mentioned, it is a good clash of styles here in this game. You have the utmost speed in the National Hockey League and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Tremendous team speed, tremendous team skill against a Los Angeles Kings team that still has that physical defensive element. So it's whichever team comes out really plays its better team game here tonight that should be the favors in this one.
Well, we know how good the Leafs have been on the power play so far to start this season, but it's one area that the Kings have struggled. Why is that?
They're not getting enough pucks and bodies to the net at the same time, and they're also losing some early faceoffs in the power play. It's tougher when you only have about 90, 80 seconds with which to work. Drew Doughty took a lot of responsibility on this. He said yesterday during media availability, I'm a guy that gets put out there for a reason, and I need to make a difference when I'm on the power play. He's saying that he's failed at that so far this season. Drew's always very hard on himself, and he's always brutally honest, too. Drew Doughty, it should be also said, has not yet been on the ice for a goal against in any situation this season. But you're going to look and see the Kings try and simplify things today, getting the bodies and pucks to the net at the same time. Drew said that the team had been overthinking a little bit even before hopping over the boards at the start of a power play. Just overthinking. They've got to simplify bodies, pucks to the net. It's a little bit of a challenge right now with Dustin Brown out for this LA Kings team. But that's going to be the goal here today. Get one on the power play. That could very much help them in this game against Toronto.
Hey, not uncommon for teams to get in their heads when they're struggling in a very specific area of the game. But, John, have you seen any signs that that offense is going to start coming around?
Yeah, a couple. I mean, the Kings team game so far this season is still leaving a lot to be desired so far. They took some strides forward in the Montreal game earlier on this road trip, really did a great job of limiting the Canadiens' speed and doing a good job cutting down on real scoring chances. They did give up 40 shots on goal in that game, but did take a good step in towards that Jennings Trophy real identity that the Kings had. That went out the window over the final 10 minutes, first 10 minutes, I should say, or the final 10 minutes of the first period against the Ottawa Senators 2 days ago, and their team game wasn't great. Power play did not win them that game. Second period, though, they had some good looks, generated 20 shots on goal. Of course, at that point, it was practically academic, and of course, the team that is trailing 3-0 is going to stay, you know, give everything that they've got and play in the offensive zone. But there were some signs. You just haven't seen them strung too much together, still a little bit too intermittent so far.
Well, it's only fair that we do state the Kings are missing some key pieces in their lineup due to injury. What's the latest on some of those players?
Jonathan Quick skating today back at Toyota Sports Center in El Segundo. The plan is for him to face shots tomorrow. Keep in mind, too, the Kings were hoping that they'd be able to have one of their prime young weapons, real wild card here in Gabriel Vilardi, first-round pick back in 2017. He has not yet skated since development camp right now. He's been on the ice just in a limited capacity, been skating in his gear, and the Kings are going to be taking a 3 days on the ice, 1 day off the ice approach for really the next 2 weeks. So once they get past that, they're going to evaluate him once again. At that point, wouldn't be surprised to start seeing him getting integrated into the ends of practices, and then at that point, gauging whether or not that he could take contact. But still a little ways away. Dustin Brown also on LTIR. He has to miss at least 10 games in 24 days. Should just basically be out the first month of the season. So they're coming around. Good to hear that Gabriel Vilardi making some strides, as is Jonathan Quick, who, again, for the first time, should be facing shots tomorrow.
Yeah, no Jonathan Quick. Definitely bad news for an LA Kings team, but Jack Campbell has looked pretty good in his absence. Thanks for this, John.